What is up, my Canadian cousins, my very good friends, my neighbors north of the border? So I am going to be trying something I've never done before. Mostly this is not going to be a reaction video, it's going to be my hand at a vlog. And really it's kind of a follow-up on two reaction videos I've done before. And really what this is the story of a Christmas tradition born out of tragedy, and the story of how two countries and two cities came together and 100 years later continue a tradition that is just beautiful and wonderful. And what I'm talking about is the Halifax explosion on December 6th of 1917, which was obviously a terrible tragedy. I'm going to put a link in the description below to a prior reaction I did in detail to that. I'm gonna just sort of, for context and background, go over it just a little bit in a few minutes. And the tradition of providing Boston with a Christmas tree, in thanks to that, Boston's relief efforts in the wake of the Halifax explosion. And so without further ado, let us get into the video, and please like, subscribe, and forgive my first attempt at a vlog. If it seems pretty amateurish, it probably is, but hey, you know what they say, practice makes perfect. Okay, see you on the flip side, my friends.
Look at that.
Yeah, thank God she's a half a mile away, huh?
She's loaded, boys. You gotta get out of here. It's full of explosives.
Children,
explosives.
Come on.
Oh, no. No, get out of here.
Vince.
I'm back in the school.
Please, get these children out of here. That ship is gonna blow. No.
Mr. Coleman.
Hurry. We gotta get these people out of here. That ship is gonna blow. The train.
What?
People, get out of here. It's gonna blow up.
Mission ship on fire. Stop train. Please, God, answer.
Coleman, there's no time.
The train's coming in towards Pier 6. I've got to warn you.
Come on, Vince. Come on.
There are 700 people aboard it. I've got to stop it.
Come on. Come on. Acknowledge.
Halifax was devastated. 9,000 wounded, 2,000 dead, including Vince Coleman, dispatcher.
The heritage moment that you just saw is, of course, very famous. And it is because the event that it covered, the Halifax explosion of December 6, 1917, left an indelible mark on the province of Nova Scotia and indeed all of Canada when two ships in Halifax Harbor collided, one bearing munitions headed for the European theater of World War I. It caused utter devastation in the form of an explosion that was the largest non-nuclear explosion in human history. The ship, the Mont Blanc, caught fire after the collision, resulting from an unfortunate set of human mistake. When the explosion happened, a peaceful Halifax was unaware of what was about to befall them. Instantly, 1,600 people were killed. The explosion caused a tsunami, which caused more death and destruction. Fires set the city ablaze. The devastation was everywhere. 10,000 people or more were injured from flying debris, shrapnel, from being caught under collapsed buildings. The death toll is really unknowable. And in the wake of this disaster, to add insult to injury, a massive snowstorm hit the next day, which hampered the relief effort. Many, many Canadian cities and authorities and civilians responded. But they weren't the only ones. Almost as soon as news of the disaster hit New England, the city of Boston and state of Massachusetts sped a train up to Halifax as fast as it could to aid in the relief effort. They were one of the first to arrive. Canada and Nova Scotia well remembers this terrible tragedy. The comments I've received to prior videos is proof that the memory is alive from the stories of
grandchildren and great-grandchildren of those who experienced it. But Halifax also remembers the city of Boston by providing them with an annual Christmas tree. The tradition started shortly after the explosion, but it was revived after many years. And beginning in the 1970s, till this very day, the tradition stands. I'm going to be going on a personal journey, and I've been on a personal journey, really diving deep and learning so much about my Canadian neighbors, your culture, your traditions, and it's been such a wonderful journey for me. Along the way, I've made great friends. Even though I've never met you in person, I consider you friends. And that figurative journey is going to become actual as I travel to Boston to see the Nova Scotia Christmas Tree 2022. When I consider where Boston is and where I live and where Nova Scotia is, I realize that we're really relatively close to each other. This is me, suburb of New York City on this island here. That is long called Long Island. I travel from the western part near the city to the east end here to this tip called Orient Point. I take a ferry across to New London, Connecticut, and then from there it's a short 2-hour drive to Boston, Massachusetts. Just a little way up the coast is the province of Nova Scotia. Never really thought about how close it actually is to me. Really would be a short flight. This year's tree comes from Cape Breton, a little town aptly named Christmas Island.
Christmas Island is a community of fewer than 300 people, and it's probably safe to say its population at least doubled today.
It's a beautiful day, and it's very exciting.
That's an understatement. To have the tree for Boston come from a place so perfectly named is like something out of a Hallmark movie. But this place is kind of a big deal this time of year. For years, Christmas mail has come here from all over the world just to get this festive stamp. The story behind the story is even better. This year's tree was donated by the Townsend family. The mother, Ooh. Blanche, who passed away years back, would always say that this evergreen in their yard would make the perfect Christmas tree.
Sure will. Look at that thing.
She would be over
it's
the moon.
It's going to look great on Boston Common.
We believe to see her dream of this beautiful, very special white spruce being chosen to grace Boston as its Christmas tree.
Another of Blanche's daughters, singer-songwriter Carmen Townsend, christened the event with a song she wrote especially for it, singing backup for kids she teaches at nearby Rankin School. The man tasked with cutting the tree says he knows that when it's all lit up in Boston, it represents us.
The whole province is behind it. Every Nova Scotian is behind the Boston tree, and we thank the people of Boston for what they did for us. And we just spread our hospitality. It's what we do as Nova Scotians. So thank you, Boston.
Then, the moment everyone was waiting for. Now that it's down, the next step for this tree is to be hauled onto the back of that truck behind me. From Christmas Island with love, final destination, the Boston Common. Seeing the tree ever so carefully placed on board was a spectacle in itself.
Happy holidays to you and yours from Christmas Island, Cape Breton, Nova Scotia. And we'll be seeing you soon, Boston.
Merry Christmas. Happy New Year.
Ryan McDonald, CTV News, Christmas Island, Nova Scotia.
Thank you for cluing me into that video. You know, especially because I will be in about a month's time traveling to Boston and spending a little holiday time up there. It's a great city around the holidays, but ultimately to pick up my daughter, bring her home for the holidays. And I do absolutely plan to stop in Boston Commons and see that very Christmas tree. And so not only will I have the perspective of knowing what it is in tribute to and thanks to, I actually got to see it cut down in the ceremony that surrounds that. And so it will give me a new perspective, and I certainly will tell my daughter all about it. No, and hopefully I'll maybe record something while I'm there doing that to post to all of you guys if you'd like me to do that.
But before I can fulfill my promise of a month ago, the tree must first travel to Boston from Cape Breton. Oh, and look, courtesy of Google Earth, we can see the distance that it travels all the way to Boston Common. And if you look closely, you will see the church spire that you can see in the background. And now the tree arrives. My friend, so we are off going down to my driveway on our way to Beantown, which I hope to culminate in seeing the Nova Scotia Christmas tree, the gift to Boston. And this is the part where I fast forward my jibber jabber. As I arrive at the east end of Long Island and get on the ferry to depart for Connecticut, I do reflect on this last 6 months, or not even, of doing these reaction videos and how much my perspective of the event that I'm about to witness has changed because of all of the wonderful people that have commented and joined my community, and how much I appreciate you all.
Well, my friends, after a hour and 45 minute ride from where I live on Long Island to the East End, an hour ferry ride across Long Island Sound, I am now departing the ferry in New London, Connecticut, about 2 hours from Boston. So I'm getting there.
Fast forward, more bloviating by John.
I've stopped at one of my favorite breweries in the Northeast. It's packed on a Wednesday at 2 in the afternoon to enjoy just one, because I have to be on the road. And I'm sitting here reading comments from all you wonderful people and trying my best to respond to them, or at least love them. And I don't have time to respond, but I do very much appreciate all the comments. And this is a fun little journey on the way. Thank you so much. Well, you gotta have some good road trip music, and last night I downloaded your favorites from the Tragically Hip, and that's what I've been listening to, singing very loudly in my horrible voice because I'm alone in the car.
Shut up, John, and just listen to the Hip. Okay, I arrived in Boston and got to see the city skyline from my daughter's apartment window for the first time. After a wonderful dinner with my daughter, we made our way to Boston Common.
There it is. I was really glad to see this plaque so that the people of Boston just don't think this is some random Christmas tree. And I was heartened to see that actually a lot of people were standing there reading it before I got to walk up to it. My daughter Sarah even read it, and we talked a lot about the Halifax explosion. She seemed legitimately interested. She didn't want to be on video, but hey, she's 20. She either was interested or she's gotten very good at humoring her dad. Either way, we had a great night together. And she did allow me this one picture, so I'm happy. I hope you enjoyed that, and I sincerely, from the bottom of my heart, appreciate all of you so much. I wish you a very, very Merry Christmas, a Happy Hanukkah, Happy Holidays, and a Happy New Year. I'll see you soon, my friends. Thank you.